discuss the solution of a problem from the section complex analysis, and the problem is on the entire functions, and this problem has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section C. The problem is, for Z belongs to C, the set of complex numbers, let scriptor Z, that is RZ, denotes its real part. Let F be an entire function satisfying mod FZ less than or equal to mod Z into mod real part of Z on C. That is, this is true for all Z belongs to C. Which of the following statements are true? We are given four options. Option 1, F of 0 is equal to 0. Option 2, F prime 0 is equal to 0. Option 3, the only entire function satisfying the given property, this property is F of Z is identically equal to 0, that it is a 0 function. Option 4, there exists a non-constant entire function satisfying this given property. Let's now recall a theorem from the complex analysis, that is the uniqueness theorem for analytic functions. And it states that if two single valued analytic functions f of z and g of z defined on a domain G coincide on a set E contained in G with a limit point z naught belongs to G, then f of z and g of z coincide on the whole of G. And you can see this in this book, Introductory Complex Analysis by Richard A. Silverman, and it appears as Theorem 10.8 at page 208. What are we given? We are given two single valued analytic functions fz and gz, and they are defined on a domain G, and you have a E, a subset of G, and f of z and g of z coincide on E. That means if f of z is equal to g of z for all z belongs to E, and E has a limit point z not belongs to G, then f of z is equal to g of z for all z belongs to G. That is the uniqueness theorem for analytic functions. Let's now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. Let f be any entire function. We are considering f to be any entire function satisfying the condition mod of z less than or equal to mod z into real part of z for all z belongs to C. Let g of z is equal to 0 for all z belongs to C. That means g of z is a 0 function. That is, g of z is identically equal to 0. Obviously, it is analytic everywhere. Therefore, it's an entire function. And g of z is identically equal to 0 satisfies this condition, obviously. And therefore, this is g of z is identically equal to 0, that is the 0 function is an entire function and satisfies the above condition. Let E be the set of points on the imaginary axis. On the imaginary axis, you take it. Let Z be any point from this set E. Then real part of Z will be 0 because Z is an imaginary number. Then real part of Z is equal to 0. And let's look at the condition. Mod of fz less than or equal to mod of z into real part of z is 0. Therefore, mod of z is less than or equal to 0, that implies f of z is equal to 0. Therefore, f of z is equal to 0 for all z belongs to E, and g of z also equal to 0 for all z belongs to E. In fact, it is true for all z belongs to C. So, f of z is equal to g of z is equal to 0 for all z belongs to E. So, they coincide on E. Note that, and on the imaginary axis, z is equal to 0 belongs to E, is a limit point of E. And in fact, every point of E is a limit point of E, and z belongs to z is equal to 0 is a limit point of E, which belongs to the C. And the role of the G of the theorem is played by the whole of the complex plane. Therefore, by uniqueness theorem, f of z is equal to g of z is g of z on the whole of the complex plane. That is, f of z is equal to 0 for all z belongs to C. That is, f of z is identically equal to 0 because g of z is identically equal to 0. So thus, we have given freedom for f. F is any entire function. Then our proof says that there exists a unique function, that is, f of z is identically equal to 0, which satisfies this. So let's discuss further in the next slide. So we have f of z is identically equal to 0. Now this shows that f of z is identically equal to 0 is the only function, is a unique function satisfying the given property. Let's look at our options. Our option 3 precisely says the only entire function satisfying the given property is f of z is equal to 0. And since f of z is identically equal to 0, f of 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, the option 1 is true and the option 3 is true. And f of z is the only entire function satisfying the given property. Therefore, there does not exist a non-constant entire function satisfying the given property. There does not exist because of this. So therefore, and the option 4 is not true. What about option 2? F of z is identically equal to 0. Its derivative f prime z is identically equal to 0. Therefore, f prime 0 is also equal to 0. So f prime 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, the option 2 is true. And finally, options 1, 3, and 2, that is 1, 2, 3 are true. Our final answer is the options 1, 2, and 3 are true. So that is the discussion of the solution of the problem from the section, entire, from the section complex analysis, and the problem is on entire functions. I am sure that you have understood the solution of this problem and work out some more problems on these lines on entire functions and the properties of entire functions. I wish you all the best. Thank you.